Dames en heren, we gaan beginnen met Giga's Nerd Quiz. Dus een hartelijk applaus voor Walter en Ivana.
Ah, dus dit mag in het Nederlands. Or are there people that don't speak Dutch? Nee! Oké, nou de antwoorden mogen in het Nederlands of in het Engels. Ik heb een nerdquiz aan elkaar gedraaid. Het is een experiment. Ik doe al vaker pubquiz en muziekquizzen, maar nerdquiz voor het eerst. Dus ik ben benieuwd. Je moet er wel een beetje mee rekening mee houden dat ik natuurlijk een beetje een old fart ben. Dus misschien dat het allemaal wat oude kennis is. Dus ik hoop dat jullie een beetje mee overweg kunnen. Jullie kunnen teams maken van, laten we zeggen, max 5 man. Mijn lieftallige assistente heeft antwoordformulieren. En de eerste ronde is meteen een plaatjesronde. En daar krijg je gewoon een velletje voor uitgereikt. Die plaatjesronde hoef je pas in te leveren na ronde 4. We doen straks 1 pauze. Dan kijken we wat na, hebben we een tussenstand. En daarna nog 4 rondes en dan is het afgelopen. Er is geen minimum teamgrootte. Tenzij je 1 een minimum vindt. Er zijn ook weer bij mijn liefstallige assistenten een paar pennen. Dit is vraag 1. Dus dat krijg je een velletje van. Ja, we hebben tijd genoeg. Relax. Oh.
Thank you.
we'll have to switch to English. Yes. Everybody who wants to compete has a form? I hope. Oh. Okay, so you get some time for round one during round two and three. So every round has a theme. Round two, theme, IT. One, what key combination do you use to normally exit Emacs? So I don't mean Control Z, kill all Emacs. I mean the... No, you're not allowed to use any lookup devices. Most of the time, people who don't use Emacs learn just this key sequence to get out of... Okay. Question two. Name this game. I think it was most popular on the Commodore 64. Yeah, that's really old shit. Question three. Once upon a time, Microsoft had a version of Unix. What was it called? In fact, they were the first ones in Europe to have a commercial Unix version, I believe. And it was, for a while, the best-selling Unix in Europe. It was not in my talk, no. No, just, yeah. It was popular for PCs, but not so much in universities. It was based on AT&T Unix. Four, what does the SU mean in the Unix command SU? So it's not what you might think the first time you read this.
That's a four-letter word, right? No, six.
Five, there is this kind of mythical machine language instruction that's called HCF. What does it do? There's also a television drama series about old school computing that has the same name. Six, what's iOmega's super floppy called? So this company had what they believe was the successor to the floppy drive. Many of them would get a click of death. So you could store 100 megabytes on them, but then they would just fail. Welke van de drie? Ja, er zijn 3, 4 gemaakt. Oh, which variant? I think if you have one of them, fine. No, no, one is enough. Seven is actually a movie question. What was the name of the computer, the NORAD computer in War Games? Number 8, what does modem stand for? Number 9. So if you don't know, you can still guess. Put in chronological order from old to new, Firefox, Chrome, Safari, and Opera. There was even one before Mosaic.
Blue Wave. I wasn't that old.
And the last IT question. Which YouTube video was the first one that hit 1 billion page views? I think it was a couple of years ago. Right, so we will go on with the next round. You don't have to give us any forms yet, and you still have time to look at the picture of the first round. The third round has nerd stuff, where there's a sequence of things, and you just need to continue the series. So which thing or character or letter or number or whatever comes next? Yeah, just one item. So in this case, it's one letter. X, K, C, something. For question two, I need a digit, and you cannot use a calculator. No calculators, right? Three. Hackers. Yes, I am a criminal. My crime is that of... It's the Hacker Manifesto. Number 4, Cult of the Dead. Zombies. Number 5. Kilo, Mega, Giga, Terra, Beta. Something. This is like stuff that you won't normally use, these big numbers. But number 6, hacker conferences. I want one, the one that follows this. Yes. The next in this sequence. Seven, physical, data link, network, transport. Political is a way, is I think if you go to political, you're missing two. No, 3. Then number 8, an electronics question. V equals I times, or U equals I times, if you like. Number 9, everybody knows foo and bar, but what's after bar? And the last one from this round, a bit of SMTP, Halo, Milfrom, RCPT2, and what's next? No, not an extended Halo, no. But with the extended Halo, it would be the same.
Right, that's round number three. So we'll go on to round number four, and after round four, we have a little break. Round number four is a pictures round, but the pictures will... What? This is probably very old computers. Yes, it's very old computers. Name the this is nonsense. Name the computer. What's this? I think it was the first one with handwriting recognition, but I'm not 100% sure. My God, how many were produced? I also have one, by the way. Yeah, I photoshopped away the logo. With my lead photoshopping skills. I guess that you would get half a point if you get the brand at least. Number two. So it's the thing with the couch.
Do we have to say which one?
I guess the model the model number will be difficult, but the brand. I looked it up, and an Apple iPhone 5 is faster than this supercomputer. Three. With a terrible keyboard. But cheap. Number four is a brand that also still exists. They make games. This is the early game console. Number five. This system had the micro tapes, and also there was a video, there was a chip inside with the same character set as teletext.
How did that happen?
Well, the manufacturer happened to make these SAA something something
yeah,
chips.
Very popular SAA chip.
Yeah. So this is about 1980. Now, this is a computer you might have or have worked on. This is probably a computer you've never had in your possession, because only very few were made.
Not one of Bill Hurst's designs.
number 7. No. Yeah, from the Unix factory that combined the factory that combined Unix with graphics. I'm not really sure if they still exist. Probably beaten by cheap hardware Linux. Yeah, I have an inflatable system at home. One of these. 9. This is like war games times. And number 10 is a system that also runs Unix and is beautifully made. The system is a square box made of magnesium. And if you open it up, it's even pretty on the inside. Yeah, well spotted. Okay, so we'll collect your bits of paper and we'll tally up for the, how do you say, the scoreboard after round 4. And also the first round we will also take. It's the first 4 rounds. Got a Linux port? I don't know. Oh really? But there's no way you can get one of these. I'll give you some answers. So the picture round. Well, you don't have the pictures anymore, but there were pictures from Doctor Who, Star Trek: The Next Generation. I don't believe I have the pictures here on the. Oh wait, maybe I can. This is Blake 7, very short-lived UK series. Red Dwarf, Futurama, Third Rock from the Sun, Star Trek, original, Rick and Morty, Thunderbirds, and the Jetsons. Now, I hope I know the answers from the top of my head. How do you quit Emacs? Control X, Control C. This was Impossible Mission. Microsoft had a Unix, and all Unixes end with an X, and this one is called Xenix. And it starts with an X as well, yeah. SU is not super user, but if you read the manual page, it says substitute user, because you can substitute yourself for any other user, including root. HCF was a instruction that would get the processor in an infinite loop and it would overheat and destroy itself. And people call it the hold and catch fire instruction. And there's also a television series named Hold and Catch Fire. I am working on a super floppy, super drive, zip drive. Sorry, which one? LS120. Jazz, yeah, that was later, the Jazz Drive. The NORAD computer, that was called Whopper. W-O-P-R. Colossus is a computer that they invented in Bletchley Park to crack Enigma. Modem is short for modulator or demodulator. And this I need to look up to be absolutely sure I give you the correct answer. So the first one was Opera, 1996, thereabouts. Then Safari, 2003. Firefox, 2004. Chrome, 2008. YouTube video. Psy Gangnam Style, yes. The series, XKCD, 3.14592653. Yes, I'm a criminal. My crime is that of curiosity. The hacker group was called Cult of the Dead Cow. Got one cow. Kilo, mega, giga, tera, peta, exa. Jota, zeta. Yeah, you Google Plex. Binos only goes to 10 to the 18th. Hoi, hip, hal, what the heck, har, oom. Physical data link, network, transport, session layer. Now we have financial, political. V equals I times R. Yeah, the foo bar baz. What? Sta? Sna. Snafu. Kuks, yeah, bar, kuks. Sizzy, that's from games. Halo, mail from RCPT2, and then you get the data command. Name the computer. This was the Apple Newton message pad, or Apple Newton. Cray 1. Cray. ZX80, Sinclair ZX80.
No. Sinclair ZX81. I have both computers. I own both.
Oh yeah, sorry. It's an 81. Yeah.
Thank you.
Very good. Sorry. Atari 2600. So this is my Eindhoven connection. This is a Philips P2000T in this case. This is actually a prototype. Commodore. No, the 128 is not a prototype. This is the Commodore 65. So this was meant to be the successor to the Commodore 64. This is a Digital Equipment Corporation PDP-8. Yeah, that's the cute Silicon Graphics 02. Oh, I got it wrong. That's I have to say this was the 8/E, but 8 is 8. The IMSI 8080. And this is the Next Cube, made by Steve Jobs. Let's see how the scoring goes. In due of time, we'll have the score listing when it's done, and I'll just continue with the next round, right? So I hope you all have paper. In this round, you're going to hear things. I have sound clips. Oh, yeah, so don't forget to write the team name on your new piece of paper. So you get to hear sound clips from fictional characters, and they say something, and they can be from a book, series, film, or more. If you know the name of the series that's out, it's coming from, you get half a point, but if you know the name of the character saying the actual thing, you get a full point. So let's try number one.
42. Was a tough assignment.
It's not coming through the speakers.
It was a tough assignment.
Switch the audio device.
42. Was a tough assignment.
Is that sort of doable? Sorry? Number two.
I am not a number, I am a free man!
Maybe the people in the back now. Who knew this? Who? I'm impressed, that was a tough one. Number three.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Yeah, well, you know, that's just like your opinion, man.
Just a sec.
Yeah, well, you know, that's just like your opinion, man.
No, he's a religious icon.
It's an actor who plays this, but the person he plays, yeah, is he fictional? Yeah. Or is he a god? Number five. text you heard was greetings programs. Did you hear it again, or?
Greetings programs!
Right first with the one we
greetings programs.
Six. The character. Well, if you know the series, then you get half a point. Number seven.
I know Kung Fu. I know Kung Fu.
Eight.
It's a Unix system. I know this. It's all the files of the whole park.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think anybody knows who the kid is called, but just write down the series.
It's a Unix system. I know this. It's all the files of the whole park.
Nice.
How many assholes we got on this ship anyhow?
Yo!
I knew it. I'm surrounded by assholes.
Keep firing, assholes!
Very obscure.
How many assholes we got on this ship anyhow?
Yo!
I knew it. I'm surrounded by assholes.
Keep firing, assholes!
And the last one. I hope.
How many assholes we...
Yeah. I have an audio file, but it doesn't. Let's try it another way.
What do you mean? African or European swallow?
Yeah, so that was number 10. Again.
What do you mean? African or European swallow?
Okay, and after all this fun movie literature stuff, we now go to the technical stuff. Number one, put in order of increasing melting point. gallium, mercury, silver, and gold. So the first one will be the one to melt at the lowest temperature. All at the same pressure. Number two, name this car thingy. So you can, no, you can write down the Dutch name.
Does it have to be in English?
No, no, it can also be in Dutch. Three, name an element with an atomic number of at least 100. So I think we have about 8 or so, 10, no more even, 18. Yes, in decimal. Well, they're all named after famous people and places where they find these elements, so maybe you can
use your...
Yeah, yeah. No, your anus is this question. Name the two planets in our solar system without moons. Number five, what shape does the DNA molecule have? How do we name, how do we call that shape? Six, how do you would you normally call C8H10N4O2? There are a few logical options in. That would be giving away and the druk. Another chronological question, put it in chronological order from old to new, Linux 1.0, the Trojan Room webcam, there was a webcam at the Trojan Room in the UK that showed you how much coffee there was left, the first spam email sent, and the release of the ICQ program. No, IRC was before ICQ. Sorry. Question 8. How many ohms is this resistor? And I don't want to know how much it can deviate from what you think it might be. I just want the intended ohmage of this resistor.
Are we allowed
to use our amps? No. So it's brown, black, and green. Number 9, what is the element? What? Still with this? Nine, what is the element polonium named after? And the last one. What is Globalnaya Navigaciona Sputnikovaya Sistema, also known as, or what is it? You could describe it in one word probably, or one acronym. Right, so round 7 is a special round. First of all, I don't know if this is good news or bad news, but we'll let you off a little bit earlier because I figured out I only have 7 rounds instead of 8. I thought I had 8, but I have 7. So, but round 7 is quite a difficult round, but it's also a music sound round. The first 5, you get sounds from a game. The question is, what game? And it really gets hairy for the last 5, in which you hear a sound associated with an operating system. Let's start with the games. Is the mic somewhere there?
Yep.
Near
the
okay, great. 1. Shouldn't be calling out all of the possible games because they could be in numbers 2 to 5. Number 2. Number 3.
I don't think you should drink that.
It looks bad for you.
Nonsense. It makes me feel great, smarter, more aggressive. I feel like I could. Like I could. Like I could. Take on the world.
Over het hele spel of over het opnemen?
Heel lang.
Heel lang. Number 4. I think those 5 are doable, but next is name the OS. So this will be quite hard, I suppose. Anyway, number 6. Again. You can also guess. Guessing doesn't cost you any points if you do it right or wrong. Yeah, well, you need to version it. Yeah. Well, not the build number, but. Number 7. Number 8. Yes, this is a startup sound. Number 9. Number 10.
laat ons gewoon winnen.
I was about to start with the answers, but let's first wait until we collect the sheets. Yeah. I'll get the forms from you.
Thank you.
Computers.
let's look at the... correct answers. The fictional characters.
42. It was a tough assignment.
So this was from The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, and but who is saying this is Deep Thought.
I am not a number, I am a free man.
This one's from a 1960s television series, The Prisoner, and the guy who says this is the prisoner, or number six. Also known from a hard rock... Yeah, so if you set the prisoner, then you get the full point.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
That was a whole 2001 in Space Odyssey, 2001.
Yeah, well, you know, that's just like your opinion, man.
Sorry, Whole 9000 in 2001. This was the dude in the Big Lebowski. Sorry? This is from Tron. It was not the master control program, but Flynn. I saw a lot of interesting spellings. If it looked like Tweaky, I gave it a point. It's from Buck Rogers. Yes.
I know Kung Fu.
That was Neo in The Matrix.
It's a Unix system. I know this. It's all the files of the whole park.
Yeah, Jurassic Park. I have to look at the correct name. There were two people who said Lex, so I gave them full points. The person is called Alexis Lex Murphy. Yeah. The little girl.
It's a Unix system.
How many assholes we got on this ship anyhow?
Yo!
I knew it. I'm surrounded by assholes.
Keep firing, assholes!
Yeah, so this is Spaceballs with it is actually Dark Helmet. Some people said just Lord Helmet, but I gave them all the points. Oh, and the last one.
Always have coffee when I watch radar.
Of course you do, sir.
They jammed the radar.
What do you mean? African or European swallow?
The person who said that was King Arthur. Monty Python and the Holy Grail. Technical stuff, melting point. Well, the first one is mercury that melts at room temperature. Gallium a little bit more. If you hold it in your hand, it will melt. And then it's gold, and then it's... Am I saying this right? Then it's gold. No, silver. And then, yeah, you would expect gold to be... easier malleable, but it is silver and then gold. This is there were different names, but anything that looked like camshaft, knock and os, knock thingy, I gave points to. Name an element with an atomic number of at least 100. I didn't see many of them, but I have the list here, so it's fermium, mendelevium, nobelium, lawrencium, rutherfordium, dubnium, seaborgium, borium, with an H, hessium, meitnerium, darmstadtium, roentgenium, copernicum, nihonium, fluorovium, muscovium, livermorium, tennessine, and oganesson. A what?
A
A neutron star, yeah, it has the element, but it's not the name of the element.
Uranium's element number is 238, so...
That's the weight.
No,
it's the
weight.
238? Yeah, name the two planets in our solar systems without moons, Mercury and Venus. The DNA has a double helix structure. I saw some interesting answers to this one. It's not THC, it is caffeine. And this nobody got right. And the first, let's see. Oh, did I, maybe I have to re-look into if I did it right. I have to double check. But the answer is, the first was spam email, but that was on a DECnet network in 1978. Yeah, it was a guy from DEC who mailed to 400 people. The webcam came in 1991, Trojan Room webcam. And 3 years later, we had Linux 1.0 in 1994, and ICQ is from 1996. Brown is 1, black is 0, so it starts with 1-0, and the green is 5, so it has 5 zeros after that, so it has it's a one with 6 zeros, so that's 1 mega ohm, 1 million ohm. Polonium, that was discovered by Marie Curie, and she named it after her country, Poland. And this is the Russian GLONASS GPS-like system. Let's see. Then the that was Pac-Man. Super Mario Kart. Sorry? No. If you have Super Mario. Google lied to me.
Think that it looks bad for you.
And this is the starting sequence of Day of the Tentacle. Still dreaming about it. It's Tetris. Pong. This is Windows 10. Windows XP. This could be any Windows from 3.1 to 3.11 and NT and... dit is Ubuntu, ja. Ubuntu vanaf 6.10 tot 18.04 had dit liedje. Dat is Windows 7. Let's get the results in.
Thank you. do want to find how badly we lost before I get back.
We has results. Now, we don't have 15 places, but so column C is the end result of the after the first round, and D is the total for all the rounds. Sorry. Yeah. So the first is after four rounds, and the last one is after seven rounds. Then we have team Geen Idee. Noor and Edwin. Hank. Yeah, we don't have anybody on 42, unfortunately. Also an ex-Eco. Yeah, I don't know. I can't recall at what line I started, so I don't know when we have everybody. And he's actually the number one. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed it. It's only at this point that I realized that I didn't bring any prizes with me. So you have to do with my...
We'll take the laptops, thank you.
We'll take this projector, no problem.
I'll pay us a round of bitterballs.
Right. Thanks for being here, and Evan. Have a good evening.